is Wei Zhen. I'm the group leader of TDB Biology. Catherine Chen and I co-leading this TDB Biology group. Now Catherine will give you a virtual tour of our laboratory.
I'm Catherine Chen, and I am the associate group leader of the TDB Biology group. Our group consists of 15 members, which is a mix of scientists and trainees. Our work focuses on in vitro pharmacology to support the TDB branch projects, the CRADA projects, and drug repurposing screens.
Our main lab space is capable of housing up to 20 scientists and holds the majority of our liquid handlers, readers, and other specialized instruments. During the time of shooting, Montgomery County is experiencing high COVID case numbers. So throughout this video, we will be wearing masks and maintaining 6-foot distancing. Our main tissue culture room houses 7 hoods and 10 incubators. This includes 2 Harris cell low oxygen incubators for iPS cell culturing and 1 quarantine incubator for cell lines received from collaborators. The room is also equipped with 2 inverted microscopes and an automated cell counter. Since the majority of our work is cell-based, we have strict standards of operation for quarantining and mycoplasma testing to ensure a clean environment for quality cell production. Our facility allows culturing of stem cells along with a growing number of other cell types without antibiotics, with no contamination issues. A second tissue culture room contains 3 hoods and 4 incubators, 2 of which are for low oxygen conditions. This room is designated for projects that require long-term cell culturing without antibiotics, such as iPS cell differentiation and iPS cell-derived organoid work. In the past, we have used this room to generate many brain organoids from NGLI1 patient iPS cells, which required 3 months to differentiate and mature. Other specialty labs include the bacteria and fungi room, the imaging room, and our BSL2+ room. This is where we use BSL3 procedures in a BSL2 setting as an extra safety precaution. In the past, this room was used for our Zika and dengue virus research, and currently it is being used for the malaria and Bitox projects. Next, some of our group members will take you through our lab spaces and show you the different resources that we have.
Our lab relies heavily on miniaturized assays using 384 and 1536 well plates. Therefore, we rely heavily on the multi-drop and other liquid handlers to dispense accurately cells and reagents. The multi-drop is our workhorse cell dispensing mechanism that has an 8-tip dispensing powered by a peristaltic pump. It's able to fill a 1536 well plate in less than a minute. The BioReactor 2 Flying Reagent Dispenser, or FRD, has a 4-chip piezoelectric dispensing system. It can dispense up to 4 reagents simultaneously and can fill a 1536 well plate in under a minute. This instrument is really great for enzyme assays and whole well reads.
This is the NXDR. It's an automated pin tool that uses slotted pins and capillary action to transfer accurately 23 nanoliter of compounds from the source plate onto an assay plate. Our pin tool has interchangeable heads, which gives us the flexibility of dispensing compounds onto either a 96 well, 384 well, or a 1536 well plate formats. This is the most used instrument in the lab, and this is our primary instrument to dispense compounds for high throughput library screenings, as well as follow-up drug response testing. This is the Echo 655 liquid handler. And just like the pin tool, it dispenses compounds from source plate onto an assay plate. This is an acoustic dispenser and enables touch-free dispense for volumes as low as 2.5 nanoliters onto either a 384 or a 1536 well format. It also gives us an option of flexible dispense volumes as well as plate formats. Although the Echo can be used for dose response testing, it is best suited for dispensing matrix combination of compounds to study drug synergism.
To enable fixing and washing of cells in microtiter plate for high content imaging and the medium of buffer exchange in complex assay protocols, we use blue washer OEL-406. The blue washer is a contact-free centrifugation-based plate washer to remove medium or buffer and also dispense with 16 angled tips. The EL-406 is a tip-based aspirator and dispenser. We have two units, each fitted with different head to allow aspiration and dispenser into 96 well, 384 well, and 1536 well microtiter plate. The system offers up to 4 buffer with wash head and also offer syringe pump and peristoric pump mechanism with angled tip dispenser.
Our lab employs different detection systems for various assay readouts, from whole plate reading to laser cytometry and high content imaging. The machine here is called ViewLex. It's an ultra high speed imager for 96 well, 384, and 1536 well plates. It has a chilled, ultra sensitive CCD camera that can read fluorescence intensity, absorbance, luminescence, and time result fluorescence. And the machine can stop up to 32 plates at one time.
The Ferristar is a multimodal plate reader for 96, 384, and 1536 well plates that utilizes interchangeable optic modules of matched pairs of photomultiplier tubes to evaluate multiple assay technologies, including fluorescence intensity, fluorescence polarization, alpha screening technology, luminescence, absorbance, and time resolved fluorescence. It is also configured with injectors, which can inject and read at the point of measurement for flash luminescence readouts. We have two units, one of which has a plate stacker for high throughput screening.
Our lab has two HTAI Image Express confocal microscopes. These microscopes come with both a spinning disc confocal and a wide field mode, allowing us to have both speed and high resolution. Additionally, they are equipped with a 7-channel laser light source, as well as an 8-channel color wheel, which allows us to multiplex 6 different probes in a single well and perform high content imaging. These instruments are important for our ability to perform and develop assays in 96, 384, and 1536 well plates. One of them comes equipped with water immersion-based objectives, which allow for even higher resolution, and a liquid handling system, which allows us to perform calcium imaging assays. They are used across all of our projects, including the lysosome storage disorder diseases, our infectious disease assay development, including Zika and Ebola virus, and also for our stem and organoid-based models.
The WES is a fully automated and enclosed Western blot instrument that can separate and analyze proteins anywhere from 2 to 440 kilodaltons. It features picogram sensitivity with a minimum of 3 microliters of loading volume. It can run 25 samples at a given time, and it can give us quantitative and qualitative data in as little as 3 hours. And we plan to use this extensively for our BiTox project.
The VS7 real-time qPCR instrument allows for hundreds of simultaneous qPCR reactions with an easily interchangeable 96 or 384 well thermocycling block. We frequently use this machine for the ALGS and NGLI-1 CRADA projects.
In addition to these resources, we are also supported by several core facility groups in NCATS. They help us to maintain our lab and equipment, analyze large amounts of data, and store and track compounds. This allows us to focus on our research and work with other groups within TDB to advance our projects for preclinical drug development.